What's up guys, I'm Zedius, and this is another FIFA 17 video. In last video, we started our FUT Champs journey and got to a record of 6-8 in 14 games. This is our next 16 games. In our next video, we're going to finish our FUT Champs journey. That should be out on Tuesday. Before we get too far into the episode, I just want to apologize. Some of the footage in this episode got corrupted, or it's like really framey and slow. I did the best that I could with it, hopefully we just gotta work with what we got. Hopefully it doesn't bother you guys too much. So here we start off in our first game of this video. We have a 6-8 record now. And like I mentioned in last video, I kind of wanted to make this series more informational rather than just a commentary of goals. So I'm recording this before I've seen the comments for the next video as to if people like this or not. But I'll stick with it for now. If it's something you guys don't enjoy and you'd rather see the commentary have another topic or another area, then just let me know. And I will do my best to keep everybody who's watching these videos as happy as possible. So our topic for today is going to be gameplay. So in addition to the squad you're using, the next most important thing is gameplay. So FIFA 17 is the first FIFA that's on the new game engine. It's on Frostbite instead of the Ignite engine. Without getting too deeply into the specifics, basically there's just some major gameplay changes in how the game and the system track various things that happen within the game. So because of that, there's not a huge number of changes. Oh, look at that goal, though. I thought that finish was very nice there with the outside of the foot, low-driven shot. That's something we'll be covering today. But as far as the game engine changes, there's something you can't quite put your finger on, but you kind of feel from game to game, at least I do, going from FIFA 16 to FIFA 17. It's definitely a little bit of a difference for me, at least. But all in all, that's not a huge deal. I just thought I should mention it. Off the bat. So this year they've done a few gameplay patches, so if you haven't played the game from the very beginning, then you wouldn't know about these patches. Of course, one of the first things that EA did when the game first came out, corners were very overpowered. If you played a corner a certain way, it would be very easy to score. Goalkeepers didn't react well to them. We had Lanzini, a cam from West Ham, into the team. Keepers didn't react well to corners, so they were easy to score. Scored a lot of corner goals. I was lucky enough to pack Mats Hummels and Leonardo Bonucci on my main account early in the year, and they scored probably 15 goals between them from headers in maybe 30 games or so. So corners were really overpowered. Now, corners are definitely harder to score. You can kind of get lucky if you play it near post. Once in a while, you'll score directly from a header. It doesn't happen very often. I recommend you use a short corner, but just mess around with what works. And if you find a method that works, let me know, because I'll start using it. But I think the best method is definitely short corners, and then you can either put a cross in with that guy that comes short, or dribble in and try and play a ball across the box as we get our eighth win there from a rage quit. Now this is a really good Serie A team. That red card, I want to talk about that. So FUT Champs has a reward system weekly. This is actually a good time to get into the FUT Champs rewards. So there's a reward system weekly. There's the bronze, silver, gold, and elite tiers, as well as the top 100. Every color has a different ranking from 3 to 2 to 1. Each week, as you win games, you progress up the tiers. Each tier has a different prize. So our goal for this Road to Glory is to get at least gold 3 at this point. And here's some of that corrupted footage I was talking about. I did want to show this penalty shootout, so I left it in. Again, I apologize, but I did the best I could with it. So our goal is gold 3 every week. As we progress, as our team gets better, our goal might change. But for now, as long as we get gold 3, I'm happy. The prize for gold 3 is 2 mega packs, which are 35k packs. They have, I believe, 30 items, 18 rares. So they're pretty good packs. As well as 30,000 coins, I believe, which is going to be a huge help for this Road to Glory. And I believe you also get a 50k pack, which is a 12 all rare, all players pack, which is a really good pack. So that's our minimum goal. The other good thing about getting gold 3 is you get automatically qualified for the next weekend league when the rewards are given out. Rewards are given out on Wednesday night, depending on where in the world you are. I'm on East Coast in America, so they come out usually around 7 p.m., between 6 and 7 p.m. on Wednesday night. UK time, I believe that's between 11 and midnight. It does vary, but generally that's kind of the time slot. So back to that red Mohamed Salah card. Wow, that goal from De Bruyne, though. weak foot, though I do believe he has a 4-star weak foot, but that was a great goal. But back to that red Salah. Those cards, those red cards, are special FUT Champs Inform cards. So let's say we're playing in the month of January. So in addition to the weekly rewards, there is a monthly reward system that works the same way. You get a certain number of wins, and you move up through the tiers, and you have a monthly ranking. Obviously, you need many more wins, about 4 times the wins, because there's usually about 4 weeks per month of FUT Champs. So as you move up through those ranks, you get different prizes. So if you finish bronze for the month, you get 1 bronze card that was an inform in the month that you're playing in, so let's say January. So at the end of January, usually halfway through the next month, all the FUT Champs games you played in January will count towards your monthly ranking. Let's say your monthly ranking was bronze, you get 1 bronze inform. If your monthly ranking was silver, you get 1 silver inform. If your monthly ranking was gold, you get 3 gold informs from that month, so from the month of January. And here we do another squad building challenge. I just want to mention this quickly while it's happening. We do get Bakary Sagna there, and he's going to slot right into our team. We get Stecklenburg back, who we just put in. And this is from the marquee matchup. So every week on Thursday, EA comes out with, we get our guy Gaston Ramirez there. I put him on the trade pile because when he runs out of contracts, I'm going to switch him. So we maximize our contracts available. So marquee matchups comes out usually on a Thursday, sometimes on a Friday, and they basically highlight the big games that are happening that weekend in real life football. So you'll usually have to put a couple of players from those teams that are playing into the squad, and then fill out the rest of the squad based on the requirements, and you can get a pack reward. So that pack was actually pretty good to us. I was happy with it. It was a 25k pack, and I ran through the players. We didn't spend close to 25k, so we definitely got value. Value for that, so that was good. And back to the FUT Champs monthly rewards. Gold, you get 3, as I said, 3 of those red cards. And then elite, you get 12 of those red informs that were inform in the month of January. And you do get the inform upgraded card. You don't just get a red version of a player that had an inform. You do get the upgraded card. So let's say Romelu Lukaku from Everton, he got a second inform 87 rated card. So he will be available in this January month. If we get gold or elite for the month, we do have a chance at packing that 87 rated Lukaku card, which would be a dream come true. So let me know if I can explain that better, but I feel like I covered all my bases there. The top 100. So if you're top 100, you get 44 of the red informs. So you're pretty much guaranteed to get some top class players. Pedro leaves us there. It's the end of his loan. Good servant to the club. Not somebody I would go out and buy. But since we had him, we used him, and he did a pretty good job. So for the FUT Champs reward system, that's about it. We are shooting for monthly at least gold, and it should be pretty easy to get. If we get gold 3 every time during the 4 weeks, we will end up with gold for the month. So that should go pretty well. So having said all that, I want to get back into the main topic of this episode, which is the gameplay. There are certain gameplay mechanics that are broken. And by broken, I just mean they're easily abused. So the game is designed to score goals, right? No one wants to play on nil-nil and then have penalties, right? You want to score goals. So there are certain things that EA adds to the game that let you score goals. Balls sweated across the box. Sweated, I say. Just balls cut back across the box. They happen in real-life football all the time. They're an easy way to score. Cutting in from the inside works really well in FIFA. And here, I think, comes another ball across the box. Yep, and an easy goal. Low driven shots this year, they added it in, and if EA add in a new feature, it usually means it's powered pretty well. It's going to be effective. They wouldn't have put it in the game if they didn't think that it was usable. So these low driven shots, particularly across the body, and that means if you're on the right side with your winger, you shoot across the body of the goalkeeper into the far post. And in doing that, it gives you a good chance to score goals. Let's talk about defending this year. So defending this year, it can be difficult. Sometimes defenders feel like they're lethargic and slow and can't get to where they're going. And sometimes they feel like they're on roller skates and you zip by players. Basically, the main key to defending is to stay in front of your guy. If you just keep the ball in front of you and don't gamble unless you absolutely have to, you're going to defend well. And it's easy to give that advice, but sometimes it's harder to follow it. I do dive in from time to time. I used to be a lot worse at it. I used to do it a lot. My defending has actually come a long way, believe it or not. But I'm always improving. I'm always trying to do better. And there's that across body shot I was talking about with Lucas Perez. Let me go to a penalty shootout here. I've made a lot of improvements by watching other YouTubers, and I'm sure if you guys are watching me, you've watched bigger people. Nepenthes gives a lot of good tips. Bateson, Nick28T, they all give good quality gameplay tips. If you're looking for like full tutorials, I can't recommend Dirty Mike enough. He does really good tutorial videos. Explains controls, explains why they work, explains different variants. He's actually how I started watching YouTube, so can't recommend him enough for actual tutorial sort of stuff. And if that's something you're looking for from me, I'd be happy to make some videos like that, gather clips and walk through step by step of those steps. We buy a new midfielder from Watford. Look at the stats on him. No stat below a 71. And I was talking about in last episode, you want your center mids to be good all-around players. And he is the definition of a good all-around player. And so you can see we have 11 wins there with 18 games to go. We're doing really, really well. That's 11 wins and 11 losses. So my goal for FUT Champs, if you can stay around 500, around an even record, you're doing very well. Because if you think about it, you were playing against the best of the best. You can't get into this tournament without beating players 4 times in a row. Or the other way to qualify is get promoted from Division 2, hold Division 1, or win the title in Division 1. But you're playing against the top quality players in FIFA Ultimate Team. And if you can win half your games, you're doing a fantastic job, in my opinion. Even if you can win 12 games, I think you're doing well, because think about all the people who play this game and don't make it into FUT Champions. There's quite a few. I wish EA would give us the numbers on that, but I know people who have tried and cannot qualify. So don't feel bad if you can't qualify. Work up to it. Make coins in divisions. Buy a better team. Follow gameplay tips, and you will be able to get there eventually. 9.0 rating for our new central midfielder in that game, so definitely a good purchase. So as far as more gameplay mechanics. Passing in this game, I feel, is pretty good. So you can play that tiki-taka style. And that formation there, that he just had, the 4-1-2-1-2 second variation, the narrow variation, play that. If you want to play that possession-based tiki-taka sort of game, or the 4-3-1-2, which is the three center midfielders, the CDM moves up. Look at that free kick. That's from that center midfielder I was talking about. Decore? Something along those lines. Apologies for not pronouncing that as well as I should. And this game was over by now. It was the 120th minute. I was down 2-0. I wasn't going to get back in the game, but oh my gosh, that goal. And an 8.9 man of the match for him again. So absolutely a great purchase. I couldn't recommend him enough. One of the best non-rare players I've used, right alongside Gaston Ramirez. But anyway, the tiki-taka passing in this game, I feel is good. I feel you can move the ball well. Players make decent runs for the most part. This is a tip. If you tap the R1 button on PlayStation, that top button on the right side, if you tap that, a player will check into you for a pass. If you tap the L1 button on the other side, they'll make a run into space. So the tapping to check in is something I'm trying to integrate into my gameplay. I didn't even know about it until this year. I do use the run into space quite a bit, but the checking in I haven't used as much, but it's a very valuable mechanic if you are looking for the ability to pass the ball quickly, move the ball, and this defending, oh my gosh, that's sickening to watch. I was talking about don't dive in, and there it was. And this game was a disaster. End up losing, I think, 4-0. We just write that one off and move on. And this is a tip, particularly for FUT champs. You have to play 40 games in 3 days. You used to have to play 40 games in 2 days, and that was a real grind. But 40 games in 3 days. Don't let games get to you. You play a game, you win the game, you lose the game, you move on. You put that game in the past, you move on. If you lose a particularly difficult game, you stop, you take a 30-minute break, you come back to FIFA later. And this is another Real Sociedad versus Sevilla, another squad-building challenge. We get a rare gold pack here. When I did this on my main account, I got James Rodriguez, 60k player, 87 rated cover star. And here, not quite as good. Guardado, Mexican center midfielder from the Eredivisie. And a couple other players. This was valuable for the contracts. We used those contracts, didn't have to buy any. That sold for 1,100 coins, which is good. I've been not showing you exactly what happens with all my coins. I've just kind of been giving you an idea. I haven't exactly been showing you what I buy and sell, when I buy and sell it. If that's something you want me to be more careful about, let me know in the comments. I promise you guys, I'm not spending money on this account. Yeah, you'd know if I was. I'm doing this, you know, completely on the up and up. And if you want me to be more careful about it, I can. It's just sometimes capturing that and uploading that, it's kind of time consuming, and editing all that stuff. So Lucas Perez gets dismissed from the team after his loan. I actually thought he was very good. Scored a lot of goals. He is someone I would consider. 4-star skills at striker is really, really good. Amrabat has it too, which is why I like him so much. And we bring in Max Gradle, 4-star skills on the wing. A lot of pace, fills in when Walcott is injured or tired. That goal, score goals like that. Coming down the wing, in the box, Berba spin to the inside, near post. I've explained it before, the goalkeeper moves. He moves off the near post, and it's a gameplay mechanic. It's bad gameplay, and abuse it. Use it to your advantage. What a goal there. That angle was crazy. But use that to your advantage, that the guy moves off the line. Play that near post, low-driven shot. That was a disappointing loss there. I felt I was better than that guy, even though the stats didn't show it. That particular game, I remember, I felt I was in control. There's Jesus Navas. He's going to come in as our backup right winger. This is a really good BPL team. Ross Barkley is probably someone I'm going to get eventually. 6'2", 3-star skills, 5-star weak foot. 5-star weak foot is valuable in this game. Very valuable. Whether it's at cam, particularly striker, wingers, because of the low-driven shot, having the ability to do that on either foot is definitely something that you should value. And then a cam, even center mid, having the ability to just ping a pass no matter where the ball is at their feet, definitely valuable. So as of now, I believe we are getting towards the end of our Foot Champs run in this video. I played all my games on Friday and Saturday. As I'm recording now, actually I left 10 games for Sunday. As I'm recording now, I'm about halfway through those 10 games. I don't want to give away where I'm at, but let's just say I'm happy with it. I think it's going pretty well for the moment. But if your run in Foot Champs isn't where you want it to be, isn't as good as you hoped it would be, your first time around, don't get discouraged. Try and qualify again, get another go at it, and I'm sure you'll do better the more you play, the more you get used to it. It's a stressful game mode, it is, because everyone's competitive, everyone's trying to win. It can definitely be a challenge, but in my opinion, it's the most rewarding in FIFA Ultimate Team. Not only do you get insane rewards, in no other FIFA have we been able to get the kind of coin and pack rewards just through playing the game. Granted, it is a lot of games, but in my opinion, totally worth it. Especially those red Foot Champions cards. I'm really looking forward to get some of those on this account, even if they're not great players. You know, it's still something cool to have as far as that goes. But here, we got to Silver 1. It's our 14th win. We're definitely in good shape. And we have 14 wins with 12 to go. So with that 12 to go, we only need to win 4 of them, 4 of our 12, to get our goal of 18 wins, which is goal 3. Here we add in Hector Bellerin and Dele Alli. I got to a high enough level in the catalog to put them into the team. Hector Bellerin, by pretty much all accounts, is either the first or second best right back in the BPL, depending on who you talk to. He's just so fast. I think he has 96 or 97 pace. Nobody is outpacing him in the game. He can catch everybody. Same thing with Kyle Walker. Kyle Walker's the other right back that's usually in contention for not only the BPL, but the whole game. Not too many right backs are as good as those two. Even though their ratings are so low, they're just fast. They're fast and they have good enough defending. That goal scramble there, I wanted to leave that whole thing in. We worked hard for that goal, but we did get it, so that was good. We also added Dele Alli, who's a good English young BPL cam. I believe he has an inform this week. It's going to be a long time until we can actually afford to buy informs, because we're still bettering the team. We're still completing some squad building challenges. Actually, right now, as soon as I finish my FUT Champions games, I'm going to go through the club and sell what we don't need. This is not going to be a club where we keep a lot of players just hanging around for fun. At least not in the beginning. We need these coins. We need these coins to better our team. We need these coins to perform better in FUT Champs. And we're going to sell what we can and use what we can. So if we can make the coins, that would be great. And here is some of that corrupt footage. I just wanted to leave it in that this whole game got corrupted. So I just wanted to leave it in to show you guys what it would have looked like, and it's not pretty. So hopefully we avoid this problem in the future. There's really nothing I can do about it, unfortunately. I have no control over how it gets recorded, at least as far as this goes. But that was a good team there. He is using the 3 at the back, and he was pretty good with it. I believe we lost that game. I think I show it coming up right here. But there's no way I would have been able to show the game. You wouldn't have seen anything. Yeah, we do lose 2-0. And I think that's the final game of the episode. So I look forward to giving you guys the last 10 games. I think we're on 15 wins there, 15 wins, with 10 games to go. You can see it there. So so thanks, guys. I appreciate you watching the video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And thanks. Bye.